are going to revise the poem Legend of Northmen. First of all, let me explain you that this poem is a ballad. What is this? This is a ballad. Why it is called as ballad? And moreover, it contains a story which ends up with a moral lesson. So this is the reason why it is called as ballad. Okay, so in this poem, the poet is writing about the story of a region where the nights are longer than days. It means that the winter is prevailing there, and it is because of this reason, and it is because of this reason the people, they have to pass the time. They have to pass the time, and ultimately what they have to do, they have to share certain stories with each other. And just because of this reason that what they are doing, they are sharing this legend. And every child in Northland, okay? Northland is the extreme Arctic region where it is most of the time it is covered with snow. So because it is covered with snow, people used to cover themselves in furry clothes. They used to wear thick woolen clothes, and the children, they are always covered up in furry clothes. And because of this reason, they look like beer cubs. Okay? So they look like beer cubs, and you can say as small as, okay? So these are what? These are the examples of similes. Okay, mainly simile is used here in this poem, right? So you should know also for each and every poem which literary devices are used here, right? That is also very important. Okay, so for the explanation of this poem, let us start for the legend of Northland. Away, away in the Northland, where the hours of the day are few, and the nights are so long in winter that they cannot sleep them through. So what the poet is saying that far away in the region of Northland, okay, where the hours of the day are few, means the days are very short, okay, and moreover, the nights are long in, are long as winter, okay. Then during the winter time, what is there, that the nights are very long. So the poet is saying it is the time when the winters are long, and they cannot sleep them through, okay. And poet is also saying that the people, they are not able to sleep for such longer hours. So here, can you tell me which literary device is used here in this paragraph? Enjambment. Why it is enjambment? Now tell me. Why enjambment is used? Yes, because when there is no use of any punctuation mark after the ending of line, and the idea of the one line, it is carried forward, it is rolled on to the next line. Okay, so this is called as enjambment. So here in this, enjambment is used, okay? Alliteration, yes. Okay? Alliteration, give example. Away, away. Away, away. Okay, right. Away, away is an example of alliteration, okay? So, where they harness the swift reindeer to the sledges when it slows, and the children look like beer cubs. So what they do? They used to harness the swift reindeer. It means they use the power of the reindeer in our, for transportation to move the sledges. You know what is a sledge? Okay, it is a medium of transportation used in the snowy areas. It is without any, you can say it is without any wheels. Okay, and moreover, at the base of the sledge, you can say wooden sticks, they are attached, which are smooth enough to slip over the snow. So, to the sledges when it snows, and the children look like beer cubs. And how the children, they look like? Yes. They look like beer cubs, and in their funny furry clothes. So why they look like beer cubs? Because they are wearing funny furry clothes, and in these funny furry clothes, how they look like? They look like beer cubs. They tell them a curious story. I don't believe it is true. Now the poet, yes, funny furry. Okay, here alliteration is also used. Moreover, F and F. This is an example of consonants also. Okay, so they tell them a curious story. I don't believe it is true. The poet is saying every child is being told a story, but the poet is saying, but I don't believe that this is a true story. And yet you may learn a lesson if I tell the tale to you. Now the poet is saying, but if I tell this tale to you, if I tell this story to you, you will definitely learn a lesson out of it. Again, there is use of enjambment here. Okay. So once Once when the good Saint Peter lived in the world below and walked about it preaching, just as he did, you know. So once there was a time when there was Saint Peter. So when the poet is using Saint Peter, the name is Peter. So why he has used Peter? Okay, right. It's an apostle for Jesus Christ. Moreover, he is giving it a, you can say, he is taking an example or he is referring to the famous name from the, you can say, holy book Bible. So this is which literary device? When a reference to a name is made, it is allusion. Okay, so what this literary device is, this is called as allusion. Okay, so this is called as allusion. Okay, so the poet is saying that it was the time when the Saint Peter, he lived in the world below, means it was not at hilly areas, down the plains he is living, and he walked about it preaching. What was his work? Preaching. Naturally, the saints, what job they used to do? They preach. They move from one place to another in order to preach people, in order to give sermons, religious sermons. He came to the door of a cottage in traveling round the earth where a little woman was making cakes and baking them on the hearth. Hearth is a furnace. Okay? Furnace. Okay? In which very high temperature is maintained in order to bake or melt the things. Right? So here where he has come, he has came to the door of a cottage. So at the door of the cottage, what he was doing? That there was a woman. What she was doing? Little woman. What she was doing? She was baking the cakes. What the little woman was doing? She was baking the cakes. Okay? And where she was baking those cakes? In the furnace, on the hearth. Then, and being faint with fasting, for the day was almost done, he asked her from her store of cakes to give him a single one. So being faint with fasting. Now the poet is saying that because the Saint Peter, he has traveled long distances, he has covered a long distance, so he has not eaten throughout the day. This is the reason why he was faint with fasting. Okay, he has almost been fainted with fasting because the day was almost over. It has turned out to be evening. And he asked that woman from that, as she is having number of cakes, so please give him a piece of cake from the store of the cakes that she is having. So what she did, she made a very little cake. But as it baking lay, she looked at it and thought it seemed too large to give away. So what she did, she thought to make a very small cake. Okay. From her, you can say conscious. Okay, from her you can say conscious that she is making a very small cake. But when she baked it, she found that it is not too small and it is too large to be given away to Saint Peter, because she was greedy in nature. She did not want to help any human being. Therefore, she needed another and still a smaller one. But it looked, when she turned it over, as large as the first had done. But then what she did, she took another small piece of dough and kneaded it to soften it. And again baked it. Again, what she thought, again it is of the same size as that of the previous one. She was not ready to give it to Saint Peter. Then she took a tiny scrap of dough. Then she took a very small amount of dough and rolled it flat. And she has flattened it in order to bake it, and baked it thin as a wafer. So when it was baked, so how it comes out to be only a thin wafer. Okay, so this is again an example of enjambment used here. Okay, and she couldn't part with that, but she was not ready to part with this piece of cake also, and she was not ready to give this piece of cake to Saint Peter. For she said, my cakes that seemed too small when I eat of them myself, and yet too large to give away, so she put them on the shelf. So she thought that her cakes, they are too small for her. If she wanted to eat, then they are very small to be eaten. But if she wanted to give it to another, then they are too large to be given. Okay. So what she did, whatever the cake she has baked, she has put it on the shelf. And she was not at all giving to Saint Peter. Naturally, this would evoke the anger of Saint Peter. The good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was hungry and faint, and surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. So this turned, or this made Saint Peter angry. He turned out to be angry. And ultimately what he thought, that such a woman, she is responsible for arousing the anger of a saint also. And he said, you are far too selfish to dwell in a human form. You not at all deserve a human form. You don't deserve to be a human form. Means why? Because you are not deserving all this kind of comfort as well as facilities that you are enjoying. You should be like a bird to have both food and shelter and fire to keep you warm. You are thankless, but you should be thankful because you are getting food and shelter, and moreover, you are also keeping yourself warm. Now you shall build as the birds do, and shall get you scanty food by boring and boring all day in the hot dry wood. So now what you would do, you should now be a bird and move from one place to another in the search of food. How you will find your food? By boring and boring. Okay, by boring and boring means by making holes in the barks of the trees. This is again an example of repetition. And all day in the hard dry wood. Then she went up through the chimney, never speaking a word, and out of the top of it flew like a woodpecker, for she was changed to a bird. So what happened now? She has, with those words of Saint Peter, she was passed onto a chimney, and while passing through the chimney, she came out as a bird. To which bird she was changed to? She was changed to a woodpecker. Okay, and ultimately all her clothes were burnt. She had a scarlet cap on her head, and that was left the same. But only the red colored cap that she was having on her head, it remained so. Okay, it remained the same, and rest of the clothes were burnt black as a coal in the flame. Black as coal again is an example of simile. And every country schoolboy has seen her in the wood, where she lives in the trees till this very day, boring and boring for food. So now this story is known to every school-going boy who is going from one place to another. And they very well know this story, that once there was a woman. So what happened? That she was changed into a woodpecker. So why she was changed into a woodpecker? Because she was greedy. She did not want to help anyone. Okay. And this is the reason why Saint Peter, who has the power to change human form, so what he has done, that he has changed her into a woodpecker. Okay. That he has changed her into a woodpecker. Okay. So, right. That's it. It's clear now. Okay, so this is all about legend of Northland. And I hope that all the literary devices are also clear to you. Okay, next, as in today's test, you will have your grammar also. Let us revise the rules of grammar. So first of all, I'm taking the example of subject-verb agreement. You know what is subject-verb agreement? That the verb, it always agrees with the subject. When the number as well as person of the subject is changed, then what happens? The verb also changes. For example, these are benches, or this is a bench. Okay, here I'm changing the number. Okay, right? Then of the subject, then afterwards, for example, Ram is a good boy, they are playing cricket. Again, I'm changing the number of the subject as well as I'm changing the person of the subject. So when the number as well as the person of the subject is changed, then what happens? Verb also changes. So what we have to, you can say, follow certain rules in order to remember this subject-verb agreement. So what is the first rule that you remember is that whenever the two subjects, they are separated, they are joined with and. Okay, so then what they take? They take which verb? Singular verb. Sorry, they take plural verb. Okay, for example, Ram and Shyam are good friends. Okay, but when two subjects are joined with and, but they refer to one idea, then what they take? They take singular verb. For example, bread and butter. They refer to one idea. The example you are giving, it is referring to one person only. Okay. So here it is, the two subjects, when they are joined with and, but they refer to one idea. For example, bread and butter. is a very light breakfast. I like rice and curry. Okay, slow and steady wins the race. Time and tide waits for none. Okay, right. So next is when the two subjects, they are joined with and, but they refer to one person only. Okay, then also they take singular verb. For example, yes, the poet and the writer has arrived. Okay, he is my guide as well as friend. Okay, so it is referring to only the only, it is referring to only one person. Okay, so next afterwards we are having, yes, when the subjects, okay, when the two subjects they are joined with as well as or with, then what they take, okay, then what they take, they also, the verb, it, you can say it follows the first subject, verb, it follows the first subject. For example, I as well as you am interested in this project. Okay, I, it is, yes, it is, you can say it is referring to the first subject only. Okay, right. I as well as you am interested in this project. I as well as it is with only. Yes, right. Okay, for example, you can say with you can give the example. For example, the president with the cabinet minister is arriving here. But if I will say the cabinet ministers with president, then it will be are arriving. Okay, it means it is referring to the first subject. Okay, then afterwards, when there is use of either or neither nor, okay, then how it is referring? Singular verb it is taking. For example, either you or he has broken the window. Okay, right. Okay, will participate. Okay, this is future. They, isme to agreement hai nahi, right? Next after, but here in this, what is the another case? When the two subjects, one is singular and one is plural, then how, which verb it is going to take? It is going to take, it verb will agrees with the subject which is nearer to them. Okay, for example, either you or their friends are going to attend the party. It means the friends are the nearer subject, so it is agreeing with the near subject. Let me change it to singular. Abhi maine plural rakha na isko. For example, neither they nor I am going. Okay, so otherwise in speaking you are not using this am. Okay, but here what is there, you have to use am. Okay, so this is the right place. So whenever there is use of each, every, okay, each of, many, then what they will take? Singular subject. Okay, singular verb they will take. For example, each of the student is present. Every student in the class is given an assignment. Okay, many student in the class is present. Okay, so what we use singular verb. What we use singular verb. Okay, and when there is, you can say, when singular subjects, they are joined with besides, or you can say and not. Okay, then also what they will take? They will take singular verb. For example, Sheila, besides his friends, is coming. What it will take? It will take only singular verb. Then some of the verbs, they seem to be plural, but they are singular. For example, some subjects, politics. Politics is a dirty game. Mathematics is an interesting subject. Aerobics is a good exercise. Economics is related to money matters. So all these are the subjects which seem to be plural, but actually they are singular. And some of the subjects, they seem to be plural, but actually they are taken as singular. Then give examples. Children are, they seem to be singular, but they are plural in nature. Okay. For example, people are enjoying crew. Okay. The wages. Okay, then news, singular, it will be singular. News is, okay, news is always taken as singular. Okay, then afterwards we are having another example. Then the name of the countries, Okay, United States of America, United Arab Emirates, which are formulated of small states. Then how they are taken? They are always taken as, they are always taken as one unit. Okay, then they are taken as singular. Don't take United States of America are celebrating. No, it is celebrating. Okay, then afterwards we are having another rule, that sum of the quantities. Okay, they are taken as singular. For example, the bananas are sold for a dozen. Yes, 2 rupees. Okay, 5 kilometers is a short distance. A 10 rupee note is with me. हम ये तो नहीं कहते 10 rupees notes are with me. Okay, a 10 rupee note is with me. Okay, so then afterwards we are having the examples of collective nouns. When we are talking about the collective noun as a unit, it will be taken as singular. But when we are talking about this individual, okay, then how we are going to talk about them? Then they are taken as, you can say, plural. For example, the committee has given its verdict, its judgment. But if I speak the members of the committee, then are giving their judgments. Okay, so this is how, okay, it is going to be changed. Another example of this collective noun, crew, members of jury, bench of judges, singular it will take. Okay, and the last one is when there is relative pronoun. Now in case of relative pronoun, what, how the verb agrees? It agrees with the antecedent. What is antecedent? To which relative pronoun is referring. For example, this is the man who has won the award. Okay, so here who is referring to? The man, because the man is singular. This is the reason why we have used is. Okay, singular we are using. For example, they are the players who have participated in Olympics. So they are the players, because who is referring to what? The players. So the players here is plural. So this is the reason why we are using plural verb. So clear now?
Yes.
Not any doubt in subject verb agreement. And for narration also, let us revise, just go through the rules. First of all, in case of narration, you know, it is also called as reported speech. Okay, so speak one by one the rules. Yes, Vatsal, stand on this side. Yes, what is the first rule? Any rule, speak, any first rule. Start from the simplest ones. Next one, raise up your hand, anyone in this row. Boys at the back, come please. Present tense, yes, good. Okay, sit down. Let me explain first of all that when the, yes, Vita, Milan, yes. Simple present is changing into simple past. Present continuous is changing to past continuous. Present perfect is changing to past perfect. But before that, what are the other rules, which are the simplest ones? First of all, if the reporting verb is simple present or simple future, then there won't be any change in the reported speech. For example, he says, I'm going to the market. So he says that he is going to the market. It means that I'm not changing the tense. I'm changing only pronouns here, right? The next one, for example, if it will be in simple future, he will say, okay, he is a good man. He will say that he is a good man. There won't be any change. Okay. When there is any universal truth, scientific fact, historical fact, habitual action, then there is also not any change in the tense of the reported speech. For example, okay, for example, he said the earth revolves around the sun. The earth revolves around the sun is universal truth. So he said that the earth revolves around the sun. Okay. Next, for example, the day comes after the night. Again, it is universal truth. Suppose, let us take historical fact example. Okay. Napoleon, yes. Napoleon died in the Battle of Waterloo. Okay. Ashoka was a great king. Okay. So, for example, he said Ashoka was a great king. Of course, there is no doubt in it. It is a historical fact. So, how we will change? He said that Ashoka was a great king. ओके, अदरवाइज अकॉर्डिंग टू रूल क्या होना चाहिए, वॉज विल चेंज इनटू हैड बीन, ओके, बट हियर वी आर नॉट चेंजिंग. व्हाई वी आर नॉट चेंजिंग, बिकॉज इट इज अ हिस्टोरिकल फैक्ट, बिकॉज इट इज व्हाट, इट इज अ हिस्टोरिकल फैक्ट. ओके, देन आफ्टरवर्ड साइंटिफिक फैक्ट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू कूल वॉटर एट 0 degree centigrade, इट विल चेंज इनटू आइस. ओके, फॉर ओके, टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द टीचर सेड, द लॉ सेड, टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन. देयर वोंट बी एनी चेंज, द लॉ सेड दैट टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन. दीज आर द बेसिक रूल्स. नाउ कमिंग अप टू द रूल्स ऑफ चेंज ऑफ टेंसेस. नाउ इन केस ऑफ चेंज ऑफ टेंसेस, व्हाट वी हैव, सिंपल प्रेजेंट चेंजेस टू सिंपल पास्ट, प्रेजेंट कॉन्टिन्यूअस, पास्ट कॉन्टिन्यूअस, प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, सिंपल पास्ट, पास्ट परफेक्ट, पास्ट कॉन्टिन्यूअस, पास्ट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूअस, एंड इन फ्यूचर व्हाट वी आर चेंजिंग, विल एंड शैल इनटू वुड ओनली, एंड कैन, कुड, मे, माइट, ओके, दिस, दैट, दीज, दोज, देन, नाउ, देन, बिफोर, एगो, राइट, एंड टुडे, दैट नाइट, टुमारो, द कमिंग डे, the following day, yesterday, the previous day, right? So these are the basic rules. And in case of interrogative ones, you remember very well, there are two type of sentences, with yes or no answers and without yes or no answers. With yes or no answers, you are using if or whether. And most of the time, and in case of interrogative, where there is use of said, what we are using, ask. That is not at all used. That is not used. Okay? Then afterwards, all the other rules, they are followed. Subject you will place first, then you will place verb, and sign of interrogation is changing into full stop. Okay, then imperative ones, use of let, okay, or should, okay, to infinitive is used. These are the simplest ones. So that's all for revision. I hope that now you are prepared for your revision test. Okay, so that's all. Okay, that's all for today. And with all the activities, the syllabus is complete also. And now there is time for your assessment. Okay. So it is going to be done. So prepare well for your exams. Have a deep understanding of each and every chapter so that you can attempt all type of MCQs. You will have some assertion reasoning types also. Okay. Where you will be given a situation and you have to think over it. Okay. But the thing is that you will be able to do it only if you have the knowledge of the chapter. Direct questions won't be there. Few will be there. Okay. So that's all for today.